that how I have to find out the value of G and B, I have shown you. Now, same pattern I will apply, but it is not necessary to show each and everything, because that was just for your understanding that how we are going to calculate the value of G and B by dry, by immersion, and by SST weight. Now such calculation for each bitumen content is given over here in my this sheet. For example, let me start with 2.5%. This 2.5% has the three specimen, so these are the three specimen. The dry weight is taken over here for the sample number 1, dry weight for sample number 2, and dry weight for the sample number 3. The SST weight for sample number 1, SST weight for sample number 2, and SST weight for sample number 3. Then weight of the specimen when it is immersed in water, represented by C, it's given over here. Now volume, as I have told you, if this B minus C will give us the volume. By relationship between this value, 1318.5, and this value of the volume, 516.2, gave me this 2.554 specific gravity. Similarly, I have calculator for the second. Similarly, I have calculator for the third. When these three values are in my table, then I have to find out their average value. So this is the average GMB when the bitumen content is 2.5%. Now let me increase the bitumen content to the 3%. So I have shown you over here okay, that this Marshall specimen, when my bitumen content is 3%, and I have written their weights, dry weight, SST weight, then when the sample is immersed in water, weight in water, this is the volume for all three specimen, then this GMB calculated at each bitumen content, and this is their average value. So one thing you see that as the bitumen content is increasing, the GMB value is increasing. Now my next calculation, when my bitumen content is 3.5%, same three samples I have taken, the dry weight of first sample, dry weight of second, dry weight of third sample, SST weight of first sample, second and third, weight in water of first sample, second and third, then by subtracting B and C, I am going to get this volume. This volume is written over here. Now I will draw this and this, and I am going to get this specific gravity. 2.610, 2.604, 2.608, and the average of this is 2.607. Now my bitumen content is increased to the 4%. Three specimen, the dry weight of first, dry weight of second, dry weight of third, SST weight of first sample, SST weight of second sample, and SST weight of third sample. When I have immersed a specimen in water, this is the weight and water of first specimen, weight and water of second specimen, weight and water of the third specimen. The difference of these two will define the volume. Volume of first specimen, volume of second, and volume of third. Now this volume and then this dry weight is going to give me this specific gravity. This and this give me this one. This value and this give me this one, and this is the average. Again you see, okay, as the bitumen content is increasing, the specific gravity value is increasing. Now next, I have increased the bitumen content to 4.5%. You see, this is my dry weight of first specimen, dry weight of second, and dry weight of third. SST weight of first specimen, SST weight of second, and SST weight of third. This is the weight and water of first specimen, weight and water of second specimen, and weight and water of third specimen. This is the volume calculated by the difference of B and C. By the difference of B and C.
Now, first and this one, when divided, we are going to get this specific gravity.
Specific gravity of second, specific gravity of third, and this is the average specific gravity. And still you see the specific gravity with the increase of bitumen content is increasing. Now, my bitumen content is further increased to 5%. Again, I have taken the three sample. You see, this 5% and these are the three specimens. Now, with these three specimens, I am going to find out the specific gravity. It's given over here.
The dry weight of first, second and third, SST weight of first, second and third, weight and water of first specimen, weight and water of second specimen, weight and water of third specimen.
This is the difference of these two giving me the volume. Giving me this volume.
Now I will divide this value by this
2.661, 2.646, 2.618. Now give me this average 2.642. So this is my last value for this bitumen content, because I have used the value from 2.5 up to, I have gone to the point of 5%. With each bitumen content, I have calculated the specific gravity, and that's it for the description of specific gravity. Now, in my next video, we will do the analysis of Marshall stability and flow value. We will study it later. Thank you very much for seeing.